breaking news is happening now.
And that breaking news, buildings going up in flames in Ruidoso as a wildfire has officials telling some people to leave their homes. This is the first look we're getting within the city, and you can see air tankers already at work. We just got word from the mayor that 7 to 8 buildings have burned. Ruidoso police say the fire is burning on Highway 70 at Highway 48. We're told it's within town limits and heading towards a residential area.
Officials say evacuations are in place for the Pine Creek to DePaulo Road area. A shelter has been set up at Gateway Church on Sutterth. Now, we're told structures are on fire, as Shelley just mentioned. Now, we received a call into the newsroom from a resident who says a disaster horn went off in Ruidoso. And we are getting pictures into our newsroom of the fire. They were sent to us from the Ruidoso News. You can see flames burning not too far from a building there on the bottom right, and another shot of the thick smoke near some homes. We spoke with Ruidoso Free Press reporter Todd Fouque, who has been watching this terrifying scene.
I got up into the neighborhood in which most of the flames were. I saw with my own eyes at least 6 homes completely engulfed in flames. Total losses.
We do have a crew on the way to Ruidoso and bring you more updates as soon as they become available.
And the scene is all too familiar for people in Ruidoso after a massive fire threatened the town earlier this year. Flames soared 30 feet into the sky near Ruidoso Downs, leaving homes burned and 10,000 acres scorched. There was some damage to a couple stables at the Downs, but since the season hadn't started yet, no horses were there. There was no significant damage to the track. And winds are causing even more concern tonight for the firefight.
Chief Meteorologist Joe Diaz is tracking conditions. He's here with the latest.
Here's what you see across the region. You can see a pretty good line of strong thunderstorms and at least some strong winds across the region. Now, this is extreme fire conditions. I mean, it's bone dry out there, and it's one of those situations where if you get a little bit of wind, that's bad news. So the winds are out of the southwest, moving in a northeasterly direction. Last hour, it was sustained, meaning blowing all the time at 31 miles an hour and then gusting up to 47 miles an hour. Can you imagine that? That's why we're getting reports from the mayor that this fire is spreading in a northeasterly direction, still gusting up at 32 miles an hour over in the Raton area. Now, here's the situation. We were talking this time yesterday that this would be one of those times, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, for extreme fire weather conditions. Unfortunately, that's playing out today, and it will only worsen as we get into the weekend. More about what to expect in my First Alert forecast.
Encouraging news for people in Raton as more residents are allowed to return home. The track fires burned 26,000 acres since Sunday. Crews have it 20% contained. As wind kicks up tonight, firefighters are hoping their fire lines will hold. I-25 has also been reopened between Raton and Trinidad, Colorado, after being shut down for 4 days. It's been a race against time in today's firefight because of the hot, dry, and windy conditions.
And right now, crews continue to work around the clock. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez has a firsthand look beyond the fire lines. She joins us live from Frontage Road in Clayton.
That's right. I just came back from touring the Sugar Creek Canyon and speaking with crews there on the ground. And while we were inside the canyon, the wind was picking up just like it is now. It fanned the flames into some fire. Take a look at some video from Sky 7, which found some fire still burning in the trees in the north end of the ridge there. And we saw lots of helicopters working as fast as they could to douse the flames, dipping into the lake there and using that water against that firefight. About 700 firefighters are on the scene right now, working 16 to 18 hour shifts at a time, round the clock. But in these windy conditions, it's very dangerous. One danger is that the wind can knock down a tree that's already burned, which can potentially kill. Another is that the wind can pick up fire and bring it over to another area that's already burned. Not all, but some fuels.
It gets really windy. Sometimes the only thing you do is stand back and watch and try to get out in front of it and make a line and hope it holds. And we don't want to get nobody killed.
And of course, safety is number one for those firefighters. And so far, only one person has suffered from dehydration. No other injuries reported. As far as damage, 14 structures have been burned down. 8 residences and 6 outbuildings. And tonight, the fire officials will be flying over the track fire once again to gain a better perspective of how much they've contained. The fire threat has come away from the city of Raton, but it is over in the Sugar Creek Canyon, as you can see over there. For now, reporting live from Raton, I'm Ana Velasquez, KWT Action 7 News.
Fire crews in Carlstadt have also been getting ready for the wind and hope backburn operations will keep flames from spreading. The Loop Fire has burned more than 30,000 acres since it sparked Monday. Crews are making significant progress and now have it 70% contained. The fire was burning near the Carlsbad Caverns National Park, which was shut down but has since reopened. Park officials say most of the vegetation along the highway leading to the park was blackened.
You local users are helping us cover tonight's big story. We're getting a look at more of the fire damage in Raton. William Breach uploaded this photo of his truck that was caught in the fire's path. It's not the first damage we've seen of his property. Just yesterday, we showed you what was left when he returned to his house. Only a frame, ashes, and debris remained. You can help us capture some breaking news by uploading photos of wildfire smoke or any damage you're seeing to the ULocal section of KOAT.com. And be sure to stay with Action 7 News for the latest on the wildfires burning around our state. When we're not on air, be sure to head to KOAT.com for updates. You can also get new information right through your mobile phone with our KOAT app.